I'm James Williams. I design tools for Columbia River Knife and Tool. This is called the HZ6, hira-zukuri for the blade shape in Japanese. I have a vested interest in how these knives, the people that carry these knives, because I know a lot of them personally, still train people. So when I'm looking for a design for a combat knife, there's a few features that are essential. One of them is it has to penetrate. It has to penetrate easily through clothing, through nylon. Guys are wearing tactical gear. It has to penetrate, it has to go through bone, it has to go through whatever's necessary in the moment. Penetration is dependent upon shape. Broader, flatter points and stuff, even heavy reinforced ones, don't penetrate as well. It's just the way it is. When you're looking at a shape like that, you need to be able to get maximum penetration. Also, I need to get the max amount of tissue deformity that I can achieve. And it's not about slashing like this. Although this knife cuts actually quite well like this, this isn't going to solve the problem in the moment. It's more about what kind of damage can I do, what kind of tissue deformity can I create once the knife has actually penetrated. And some of you have seen my videos before, see, I like small knives. This is still a small knife that won't cut through a forearm. I'm going to tend to use them point out edge up a lot. If I penetrate somebody like this and you move away or I pull back or try to do this, I've got minimum, got a hole. That's not going to slow anybody down in a short time frame. If I penetrate this way, any movement either one of us make is going to maximize the tissue deformity. It's going to facilitate hemorrhaging, which is going to be your primary way of solving the problem. No guards. Guards get in the way in certain situations like this. This isn't Western dueling where everybody's got a long sword and doing all of that. This is going to be close, it's going to be violent, it's going to be rapid. Okay? I can't have this catching on anything, catching on my gear, catching on my clothes. So there's no catching. The sheath actually is bigger around. So it can be tucked anywhere, can wrap around stuff. I pull it out, it's out. I need to know that. How do I keep from slipping? Well, I, one, design the handle properly, and two, I hold the knife properly. So if I'm stabbing penetration, I'm gonna fit the knife right into my hand, just like this. This type of thing is inefficient, easy to block, doesn't give you the best hold anyway. This is not, it works really well. Very difficult to block. My bone structure and the knife are held together. If I happen to stab, which will frequently also be edge in, okay, but it may not be, then my thumb or my finger's gonna go over. Some of you have watched me, say, penetrate this knife through plywood. You see I'm holding it, no problem. The handle facilitates good grip under any conditions that we can basically expect a knife to work under. Hot, cold, wet, slippery, dry. Some people don't realize how slippery dry becomes, okay? So you have a tremendous grip on it. You can put finger here, thumb here, makes for tremendous grip. The sheath then has to be simple as well. I want to be able to hit the knife whichever way I need to, whichever hand, depending upon how I'm carrying it, whether I'm carrying it in my belt, whether I'm carrying it concealed, whether I'm carrying it in my tactical gear, I have to be able to hit it. So the sheath is very functional, minimalist, but holds a knife well, allows me multiple mounting options. Some mounting options, okay? So you see this clip that's on the skin do. So this is the same clip that comes with the HZ6. And it can fit different places depending upon how you wanna carry the knife. You can also figure out other ways of carrying. If you're gonna put it in your MOLLE gear, depending upon what's happening, you can also get max Velcro. Stick it through like a battle belt. I've got one on my battle belt. Pull the Velcro, stick this inside the magazines, put it back together. So now the mags are accessed here, but I can reach just over and inside very easily and also access the knife. And you want to be able to do that because the knife can do many things, including maybe cutting somebody out of seat belts, cutting clothes off so I can see about a wound, depending upon who's the first person there and what you have to access. So a versatile knife is very important. And one that's designed specifically to do the most dangerous job, even if it'll do other jobs, you want to know it will do the most dangerous job the best that can be.